Hello guys and welcome back for a brand new review. If you are new to the channel, please make sure you're gonna subscribe. You can leave also some comments in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed the content. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at a pair of Nike shoes. So let's go ahead and take them out of the box, guys. As you can see, this time we have a box which is not your usual black or orange box from Nike. As you can see, it has a very nice drawing on the actual box, but rather than that, we just have a Nike logo here and the actual sizing tag. So let's go ahead and take them out, guys. Inside, as you can see, we have a very nice wrapping paper in this white color, which has the Nike logo and the Bedouin written on it. Okay guys, so in today's video we're gonna have a look at the Nike Bedouin Hyper Royal. Was released on the Sneakers app for a retail price of £115, and I need to admit that when I first saw them online, I wasn't too drawn to them, but I was actually a bit more curious than usual, so I decided to take them. So this one is actually based on a sneaker which was released back in the 80s. But it was under the radar, if I can say so. As you can see, it's not a very good looking shoe, but I guess there is a market for these ones as well. So the actual name in the 80s was Bedouin, but now they decided to change it into Bedouin. So let's go ahead and see why this name is now called Bedouin. So the B word, it's actually coming from be conscious of climate change. The do one, it's do take action against climate change. And the last one, the win, it's win the battle to prevent climate change. So it's quite obvious that this one is trying to get your attention on the actual climate change. So let's go ahead and do a breakdown of this shoe, guys. As you can see, most of this shoe actually has a synthetic suede going almost throughout all of the shoe in different colors. So the first one will be in this dark gray here at the front of the shoe, which will cover the toe bow section, and it's also gonna be here at the heel section. Then we're gonna have this blue one, which will cover the lateral and also the medial side of the shoe. And then we're gonna have this green one, which will act as a lacing system. And of course, the last one will be this yellow one, which will cover this color here at the ankle section. And besides all of this synthetic suede, we're gonna have this nylon material, which will cover the top part of the toe bow section and tongue. And it's gonna be in this burgundy color. Of course, the actual tongue will have some slight padding, but don't expect too much. So this one is actually quite minimal. And on top of this tongue, we're gonna have these laces, which feel that they are actually made out of an old carpet, if I can say so. So as you can see, we're gonna have actually two pairs of laces, one in this red color and one in this faded blue. Inside, I will need to add that we don't actually have any padding on the actual walls of the shoe. And a very nice touch from Nike is that the actual insole inside is made out of this cork infused material, and it also has this Bedouin written on the heel section. And this Bedouin is also gonna be stitched here at the back of the heel section in this multiple colors, which again looks quite nice. And now, of course, we're gonna finish with this interesting midsole, which has a very strange shape, I will give it that. But in my opinion, this one really feels like the one used in the space hippie range, where we actually have a lot of recycled material in the actual midsole. So this one, as you can see, it has a very strange shape, which feels like someone made this one out of clay and just decided to stick it on the actual shoe. Now we're gonna finish with, I would say, rubber outsole, which is actually just two pads, one being here at the front and one here at the back, which is exactly in the same color as the rest of the actual midsole. So I guess this one is just to give it a bit of traction and not to slip. I'm not entirely sure how this midsole will react in time, but for me it really feels that this one will actually start to slip after you're gonna wear them for a few weeks, and this one will start to wear down. But rather than that, guys, I really feel that this one is actually a very under the radar shoe still, even after 40 years. So I guess this one will be suited for people which don't want to have of course a big Nike swoosh on the side. As you can see, this side has this Nike swoosh here embroidered in a dark blue, so it's not gonna stand out. One thing which I will need to add is that this heel section, it's not too wide, and I really felt that it's slightly a bit unstable, so you need to keep that in mind. As in for the actual sizing, I went with my true to size, and I feel that this one is actually quite snug on my actual foot, and that it's mainly because I have skinny feet. So I guess if you have a normal and wider feet, I will advise you to go with a half size up, and that is gonna be mainly because this part of the shoe here is gonna be quite narrow. So yeah, guys, this Bedouin, it's still an under the radar shoe, which in my opinion, it's not a very good looking one, but nevertheless, that's just my opinion. It still has good materials overall, even though they are all of them synthetic, but this midsole, it's not that bad. It's giving an average level of comfort. So yeah, guys, this was my unboxing and reviewing of this Nike Bedouin in this Hyper Royal color. I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. You can also leave some comments in the comment section down below, and as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.